Welcome to this video on performing RNA-seq expression analysis with DESeq2 in Geneious Prime. Let's start by preparing and mapping the data. For this example, I have a collection of 100 base pair single-end RNA-seq reads from two different sample conditions, each with three replicates. The reads have already been quality trimmed with the BBDuck plugin to remove low-quality bases. I also have an annotated reference sequence. Note that you will need a reference sequence with your annotations, such as CDS, gene or RNA, to perform this analysis. First, map the reads to the reference sequence by selecting the read lists, choosing Align/Assemble, and selecting Map to Reference. At the top, specify the reference sequence using the drop-down menu or the Choose button. To create separate assembly files for each read set, ensure you tick the Assemble Each Sequence List Separately option. I'll use the Geneious Mapper with default settings. However, if you are working with a genome containing introns, use the Geneious RNA Mapper to map your reads instead of the standard Geneious Mapper. Finally, save the results in a subfolder and save the assembly report and the contigs and press OK. Once the assemblies are complete, the next step is calculating each replicate's expression levels separately. Select an assembly file, click Annotate and Predict, and calculate expression levels to do this. If desired, you can adjust how Geneious treats ambiguously mapped reads and which annotation type to use in the analysis. I will leave these settings as default and click OK. Save your changes and choose Yes to apply them to the original sequence. You should now see a new track called Expression. This track contains individual CDS annotations. Mouse scroll over them to view the raw read, fragment and transcript counts and the normalized measures RPKM, FPKM and TPM. Or switch to the Annotations tab to view the data in tabular format. Next, repeat the steps to calculate the expression levels for the other assembly replicates. With the expression levels calculated, we can now use DESeq2 to determine the differential expression between the two sample conditions. Select the reference sequence and click Annotate and Predict and compare expression levels. For the method, select DESeq2. In the Assign Conditions section, you can automatically assign these by a specific metadata field attached to your files or by manually setting them. Ensure you assign different experimental samples to different groups. Click OK to run the analysis. The first time you run DESeq2, Geneious will download and install R and all the required packages, so the analysis may take an extra few minutes. After the analysis, Geneious will add a new diff expression track on the reference sequence. Remember to save your changes. To look at the differential expression results for specific CDS annotations, simply mouse scroll over them, or switch to the Annotations tab and view the data in tabular format. You can tweak data displayed in the table using the options in the Columns drop-down menu. The log2 ratio column shows the fold change in expression between sample conditions A and B. A positive value means the gene is upregulated in sample condition B versus condition A. Negative values means the genes are downregulated. The adjusted p-value tells you whether the differential expression observed is statistically significant after adjusting for multiple tests. By switching to the PCA plot tab, you can view the PCA graph, which displays the amount of variance in the data. Ideally, biological replicates should be grouped in clusters. In the next tab, you can view the volcano plot, which shows the fold change plotted against the significance. Any outliers represent the most highly differentially expressed loci, and mouse scrolling over a point will reveal the gene name. Since the annotations table and volcano plot are linked, you can sort the data by an output, such as the differential expression absolute confidence, and then select the top 10 genes. Switching back to the volcano plot will then display the gene names for the top 10 genes. By selecting the Advanced button, you can also adjust the appearance of the volcano plot. such as adding vertical and horizontal lines at a specific cutoff and changing the color of the outliers. And that's how you can perform an expression analysis with DESeq2 in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit Geneious.com.